Many people feel that they face physical and mental hardships in today's society. But have you ever thought about the strenuous work that farmworkers face? Do you truly know the amount of physical, mental, and emotional strain they face on a daily basis? Through the Wage and Hour Division, which is a federal office responsible for enforcing labor laws, farmworkers' rights include information about their job, safe and clean housing, payment at a proper rate for every hour, and safe transportation. These rights are often unfollowed by employers, causing farmworkers to encounter abusive labor practices. Issues such as poor housing, wages, and conditions overall are still prevalent in today's society. Farmworkers work under unhealthy or dangerous conditions and are forced to live in gross housing. Many of them are also undocumented and live in fear of deportation. One of these workers was Librada Paz. She fled Mexico due to the corrupt government and low-paying jobs and came to the United States. Her life as a farm worker consisted of sharing living quarters with 16 people, working 14 hours daily, and suffering abuse and sexual assault. Since the time of her high school graduation, throughout graduating from Rochester Institute of Technology, she advocated for farm workers' rights and continues these works today. Inhumane labor practices have been affecting families and people working in the fields throughout decades. The Universal Declaration of Human Rights states that people of all nations shall be treated equally no matter what. Many people have worked and continue to work for equal treatment and working conditions. It is why Librada Paz is taking an initiative and working to follow in the footsteps of people like Cesar Chavez to protect those who are here to do one thing, work. Throughout the years, she has marched in towns, faced down senators in hearings who have questioned workers' integrity. She's been a part of the promising advances that have been made in New York, including the passing of 3 new laws that protect farm workers' rights to clean water facilities, sanitation facilities, and a standardized minimum wage. It's crucial to keep moving forward and continue improving farm workers' lives, but also we should remember those from the past and keep our hopes high for the future. Taking a look at the past, one of the most influential and memorable people was Robert Francis Kennedy. Throughout his candidacy for President of the United States, Kennedy worked with Cesar Chavez. Together they worked to create equal rights for all and to improve the rights, living conditions, housing, and overall treatment of farm workers. Through interviews, rallies, and marches, RFK was able to spread his thoughts, messages, and ideas about the migrant farm workers. He was able to set forth the path for those in the present, including Librada Paz, as well as those to come. As beautifully stated and executed by RFK, "And I come here to say that we will fight together to achieve for you the aspirations of every American. Decent wages, decent housing, decent schooling, a chance for yourselves and your children. You stand for justice, and I am proud to stand with you. Viva la causa." Many organizations have begun to rise in order to help give these workers rights they deserve. In Toledo, Ohio, an organization named the Farm Labor Organizing Committee, FLOC, is a labor union that represents migrant workers in the Midwestern United States and North Carolina. This organization gives aid to those experiencing unfair wages, poor housing and living conditions, abuse or unfair treatment from their employers. They educate migrant workers of the rights they have, help them find new and stable jobs, and find ways off the farm. Marches and rallies have made slight change in the housing and wages workers receive, but their overall treatment has not improved, nor are their housing or working benefits, which would include insurance, healthcare, and workers' compensation for when they get hurt on the job. When looking at the work people like RFK and Cesar Chavez have done, we see change. It's important to commemorate people like Librada Paz and the work she is currently doing. As a result of the great work she's done, she won the RFK Award from the Speak Truth to Power organization in 2012.
Those students are the best age to teach our lesson about the farm workers' right, because actually we will find a lot of those ages working in the farm or working in the field, and they struggle so much. So instead of them to go to school, they're working in the field. So, and then by seeing our young students learning this lesson from our teacher, it just impacts their life.
Our youth and young adults can be inspired by the things Paz has done and is currently doing in hope for the next generation to continue the movement and work for equal rights for farm workers and people of all nations.